Hey, what's up YouTube? Apple have previously dropped their new iPad Pro with a new camera module, and let's see what it's got and how this technology enables us. Now let's have a quick look into this new iPad Pro. The display of the iPad Pro is a liquid retina display, in other terms LCD display, with 120 refresh rate, 600 nits brightness with ultra low reflectivity and white color gamut, which means more rich color. And this comes in two different sizes, one with 11 inch and another with a 12.9 inch. And in terms of performance, Apple says that it is faster than the PC. It's because Apple have equipped the A12Z Bionic chip, in which it has 8 cores. Well, if you compare it with the common Intel Core i5 processor, the i5 processor has 4 cores. And this makes clear it is faster than the average normal PCs. So with that much computational power, you could do wonders like 4K video editing, 3D design and so on. And in terms of multitasking, with the lightning fast hardware and well optimized software, it's just smooth as butter. And the workflow is easier and faster. And coming to the camera module, this thing is equipped with the two camera lenses, one with the 10MP ultra wide and 12MP wide camera with the studio quality mics. And importantly, this camera module equips the LiDAR scanner. So for the people who wonder what is LiDAR, well, it's termed as light detection and ranging. While the LiDAR just emits the light and tends to bounce back on the surroundings and times the light which bounce backs and gives the raw data. And this is also called as the depth sensor. If you compare it with the new regular camera module, the regular camera module are good at focusing in terms of color. And this scanner brings the technology of AR, termed as augmented reality. For the people who use Apple devices, have you guys come across the app called MeshUp? Well, if you don't, you should really check it out, as Apple says this LiDAR scanner is more focused on improving the AR Measure app. For instance, if you guys use the Measure app, as soon as you open it, the app prompts to move the device around a bit to work properly. It's because the app tries to calibrate to know its surroundings. Well, this LiDAR scanner instantly scans the surroundings and doesn't require you to wave your device around. So what does this LiDAR scanner does out of your Measure app? Well, this can detect and classify objects in your surroundings, like measuring how tall the people are and how wide the wall is. And interestingly, for the developers of Apple, there's a framework called ARKit, where the developers can create an app based on ARKit framework and can bring new AR experiences to the devices. And the new ARKit 3.5 framework takes the advantages of new LiDAR sensor and depth sensing system on the iPad Pro to support the new gen AR experience. And few developers are using this ARKit to develop apps. As you see in the video by Mark Dawson, the LiDAR scanner captures the whole room by throwing a point light and remembers the scale of the room by meshing, even though he hides the camera by his hand. And by now you could have wondered why this isn't used for portrait mode using the depth data. Well, in that case, it's complicated and we can't expect that it on a portrait shot when compared to an iPhone. As shown in the video by iFixit, the LiDAR scanner emits a bigger point light when compared to an Face ID in the iPhone. The point light from the iPhone has enormous amount and small, as they give enough accuracy to perform as a security feature. And the portrait can be nailed easily by machine learning algorithms, as Apple termed as neural engine. So the LiDAR sensor is made for room scale sensing and it's optimized for scanning rooms in the house and for new generation of AR app experiences or AR app games. And there are very interesting and useful accessories for the iPad Pro. One of them are the Magic Keyboard. This is a pretty interesting one, as the iPad connects to it only by magnets. And when connected, it kinda looks like floating, as this Magic Keyboard brings individual hard keycaps and scissor mechanism with 1mm travel for more responsive and comfortable and quiet typing experience. And importantly, this equips a backlight, which is pretty important nowadays. And coming to the trackpad, this trackpad enables a new cursor and gesture for iPadOS. One of the gestures are the switch between apps, where you swipe left or right with 3 fingers to switch between apps. And for scrolling, you use 2 fingers on the trackpad. And for getting to the home screen, you swipe up with 3 fingers. And coming to the new cursor for iPad OS, this is kind of powerful tool for not touching the iPad when connected on the Magic Keyboard, which is basically performs most of the operations like copy pasting, editing, and navigating fluidly. Here comes the another accessories, which is pretty much useful for students and artists to bring out their creativeness. Whether you are illustrating a photo or retouching a photo or taking notes like you take it on the paper or marking up on important things, this pretty much nails it everything. And the fact that it charges wirelessly. And the portability of the device is easy and simple, as the battery can last over 10 hours thanks to the 36.59 watt hour battery. And the connectivity has a major update, as the iPad Pro equips Wi-Fi 6 and USB-C for connecting camera, external hard drive or a display whatsoever. And that's it for the video. I hope you guys enjoy watching it. Thank you for watching. Do leave a like, comment, and I'll try to answer as much as possible. And subscribe to have more videos like this.